Well, Minnesota, as we know, is not immune to gun violence, and the people who work in hospitals see it firsthand.
And tonight they are declaring this a public health crisis. Charmaine joins us now with more.
And that's right. Local hospital leaders are calling recent violence involving guns horrific and preventable, saying it's reached epidemic levels that pose a significant threat to public health.
Following back-to-back mass shootings across the country, healthcare leaders in Minnesota are sounding off on what they're calling a public health crisis.
What we are seeing is alarming numbers in healthcare in particular across our local community as well as our state and the nation that is showing trauma levels going up year over year.
Jennifer DeCubellis is the CEO at Hennepin Healthcare.
Hennepin Healthcare as a level one trauma center for both adults and pediatrics. We have seen almost 50% increase in the past 2 years.
She says as healthcare providers, staff see the impacts of gun violence firsthand every day.
As healthcare workers, it has an impact on our teams as well. So as we see that violence entering into our door at alarming rates and several incidents that have been in healthcare environments to begin with, we have the additional pressure of making sure we protect our own team members.
According to the CDC, more than 19,000 people in the U.S. were killed due to homicide involving a gun in 2020. That same year, guns became the leading cause of death for children and teenagers.
How do we do a collective call for action? How do we all put our resources, our time, our energy together?
So far this year, there have been over 240 mass shootings. As for Hennepin Healthcare, DeCubellis says they're focused on solutions.
We've got a Next Step program, which is a violence prevention program. We have expanded that year over year for the past couple of years. It's operating in other health systems as well. We know access is critical when somebody's in a crisis, that them getting the right services and supports timely is essential to getting ahead of what could become a violent action.
Now, DeCubellis says there are legislative and policy changes that need to be put into place, but says it's up to everyone to work toward solutions.